Lieutenant Colonel Alexander Vindman is testifying behind closed doors on Capitol Hill. He's the first person who was on that July 25th phone call between President Trump and President Zelensky of Ukraine to come before lawmakers. Congressman Ted Yoho, Republican and Florida member of the House Foreign Affairs Committee, is with me. Good morning, sir. Thank you very much for being with me.
Good morning, Poppy. It's an honor to be here.
Let's begin with what we know that Vindman is saying under oath right now from his opening statement. Quote, I was concerned by that call. I did not think it was proper to demand that a foreign government investigate a U.S. citizen. Do you share his concern?
Well, you know, that's his concern. He didn't think it was proper. There were other peoples on that call. Have they expressed the same thing? Do I share his concern? No, because I haven't heard, you know, what we've heard from President Trump and President Zelensky was there was no quid pro quo asked, there was no pressure, and President Zelensky didn't know about any funding. And so, no, I'm not concerned about it at all. But I am happy that it is coming out in the public.
We do know, actually, everything that was said on that call, according to the White House, because of the transcript. You've read that transcript, right, Congressman?
Yeah, I have.
Okay, and nothing in it concerns you?
No, it doesn't. You know, I think what we need to do is make sure this is not a political fight, that it is, goes through the proper technique, that we do find out the facts, and then make a decision based on those facts.
So I think one of the important things you would agree to making sure that it's not political is that of these three committees questioning these witnesses, that you have Republicans and Democrats in the room, 48 Democrats on those three committees, 48 Republicans, rather, on those committees. You're one of them. You're a member of the House Foreign Affairs Committee, so you could attend all of these depositions. Have you attended a single one?
No, I haven't gone to those. We've had discussions in our Foreign Affairs Committee on other aspects of what President Trump is doing, so I've been involved in those, not in these. I see these as kind of a sideshow, and because it's not an official inquiry in impeachment. It is something that Nancy Pelosi started without a vote. And I know it's not constitutional that they have a vote, but it should follow the precedence that has been set in the last three impeachments.
So there is going to be a formal vote on Thursday. But back to your original point, I mean, this is consequential, right? This is about whether the U.S. president is impeached or not. You're invited to be in the room for all of these depositions. Right now, you could be in the room questioning Lieutenant Colonel Vindman. Why are you not there?
Because I have other responsibilities in the House. And I see this as a sideshow. And I'm going to make a prediction that in 3 weeks from now, you're going to look back at the smoking gun and the things that everybody's so worked up today, and it'll be as inconsequential as Adam Schiff saying, I've got irrefutable information that there was collusion with Trump. And that's gone, and that was proved to be a fallacy. And I think this will be, too.
Then why is it legitimate for you to slam an inquiry and slam testimony when you have the opportunity to be in the room for all of it? You are not taking that opportunity. I understand you have other important responsibilities, but respectfully, Congressman, as glad as I am that you're on this show, you don't need to be on this show. You could be in there.
Like I said, I've
got my
questions written down for him.
Deposing Lieutenant Colonel Vindman. I ask who's asking them because your staff told us 30 minutes ago they didn't even know about the testimony.
No, they know about the testimony. I mean, we've talked about it all week long. I plan to go in there. I've got my questions written for him. You know, why was he worried? Was anybody else on the call worried? Did they express the same thing? When did he give his concerns? When did he make that publicly known? Was that written down in a record? Other than his testimony, when was that submitted? And so those are questions that I wanted to come out.
So you are going to this deposition after you're off the air with us, is that right?
As soon as I'm off the air, yes, ma'am.
Okay, and this will be the first one that you attend in the inquiry.
It'll be the first one, but we've been very engaged in what's going on in this whole vote that Ms. Pelosi's bringing up, and I'm glad she's bringing it up, but it's not an official impeachment inquiry. It's a vote to okay the process that they're going through and the transparency. And as long as we're talking about transparency, these are held in an intelligence briefing skiff, some of them. A lot of that information was leaked, and that goes against USC Code 386, that members or staff members are allowing information to be released from an intelligence briefing, and that needs to be investigated because they're going and leaking stuff that they shouldn't be leaking.
All members of the committees, so you're one of them, are allowed to read the transcripts of these depositions as they've been happening.
Right.
Have you done that?
We've read the summary of Volcker's, and there was one other one we did.
The summary, or you've gone actually to read the full transcript?
Just the summary of them, the summaries of them. And
why?
Going back to,
I get, again, you're an important member of an important committee, and this is an important inquiry, and I'm just confused as to why it seems like you don't think it's been worth the time until today to go or to read them.
Well, I said, because it's not an official inquiry. It is something they have moved with. I've had members of the Democratic Party told me that after the whistleblower came out, they were moving ahead. And I says, I can't believe you guys are moving ahead. And he goes, Chuck Schumer said that. He doesn't care if it's true or false.
So,
they're
right.
Moving ahead with this.
Okay. So it's not just Democrats here, right, who think this is legitimate and there are important questions to ask. It's also your fellow Republican
Sure.
member of Congress from your same state, sir, from the state of Florida. Listen to what Congressman Francis Rooney said to us. Mick Mulvaney laid out a quid pro quo. What is your response?
Well, yeah, whatever might have been gray and unclear before is certainly quite clear right now that the actions were related to getting some of the Ukraine to do some of these things. I think that, as you just put on there, Senator Murkowski and Mitt said it perfectly. We're not supposed to use government power and prestige for political gain.
We're not supposed to use government power and prestige for political gain. Is he right?
I don't know. I mean, I don't see it as political gain. I see it as President Trump going back to the corruption that was okay. at the base of all of our foreign aid. You know, we're not going to give that. We do that in the Central America.
Okay.
And then also that, you know, this was to go back at the 2016 election. Mm. Was there corruption in there? Was there a suppression
why
put
did,
on?
Then why, if it wasn't for political gain, Congressman, why did President Trump bring up the Bidens in the call with Zelensky on the 25th of July?
Because you got Joe Biden on the news, you know, several years ago saying how he had a quid pro quo and he forced the Ukrainian prosecutor to get fired.
I mean,
and
if you really want to
about that.
Yeah,
and I think that's something that should have been investigated under President
you're talking
Obama.
You're talking about him addressing the Council on Foreign Relations in January of
sure.
last year. He talked about holding back $1 billion in loan guarantees to carry out what every leader in the Western Hemisphere wanted, including the IMF, Christine Lagarde, saying this guy wasn't doing his job, he wasn't fighting corruption. So I don't really want to go down that rabbit hole because it's unfounded.
Of course not.
Let me just...
because it shows that Joe Biden
no.
was forcing a prosecutor to get
okay.
fired, who
That's
eventually
just...
got fired.
Yeah. Because every leader in the West thought he wasn't doing his job, and he wasn't doing his job, period. That's the reason for it. Senator, Congressman, let me just ask you one final thing, and then I'll let
sure.
you go, because I'm glad you're going in there. And you're welcome back on the
too.
Show tomorrow to talk to us about any of it. Let me ask you this. Last week, you voted against the SHIELD Act. And you know what that is. That is legislation that would require American politicians, American political campaigns, to alert the FBI and the Federal Elections Commission of any illicit offers of election help from foreign nationals. Why did you vote to oppose that?
Because it didn't focus on the right things. It didn't focus on the thing that this was all brought out about was Russian collusion and interference. It didn't really focus on that. And we saw it as a political stunt on the Democratic
what
side.
Do you mean
and
it,
I just,
what do you mean it didn't focus on that and it's a political stunt? What it would do is require campaigns to alert the FBI and the FEC if there was any attempt even of foreign election interference. How is that a political stunt?
Because it didn't go after what was going on the internet. And that's where we really have to focus is what's going on the internet. All that stuff behind the scenes that swayed people to vote or not vote, and that'll be found out in the future, you know, in future elections. This didn't really address that, and I thought it was something that was a bill that looks good on the surface, but when you get into it, it really didn't accomplish what it was designed to do, and that is interference from foreign governments in the process.
So are you proposing legislation that does that instead?
I am not at this point, no.
Okay. Congressman Ted Yoho, you have a busy day. I'll let you get into that deposition.
We do. We'll
Thank
see you later.
Bye. Yep.